Hello friends, welcome to Online Study for You. This is Pratik Srivastava here and today I am going to teach you to solve problems on edges questions in mind without using pen and paper. Yes, you heard it correctly. So please watch out the complete video to understand the tricks how we are going to solve the questions of problems on edges in mind without using pen and paper, right? Okay, so let's start with question number 1. 10 years ago, P was half of Q in age if the ratio of their present age is 3:4. So the ratio of their present age is 3:4, then what will be the total of their present age? So the total of their present age will be 3 + 4, which is nothing but 7. So your answer will be a multiple of 7. So check which option is a multiple of 7. So option A, you see, option A is multiple of 7. So option A will be the correct answer. Option B, C, D is not a multiple of 7. Multiple of 7 means 7 into 1 will give you 7, 7 into 2 will give you 14. Like this will be the multiple of 7. So this question we could have done just by seeing the question without using pen and paper, right? Okay, now let's understand the concept. What concept I have used it here, right? Okay, see, 10 years ago P was half of Q in age. So this statement I am not interested. If the ratio of their present age is 3:4, so the present age ratio of P and Q is what? 3:4. So if any data is given in terms of ratio and if you want to write in terms of value, then P age will become 3x, just multiply by a variable. So P age will be 3x and Q age will be what? 4x years, right? Okay, now they're asking the total of their present age. So the total of their present age will become 7x. 7x means what? See, whatever you will option you will get, that should be a multiple of 7, right? X value if it is 1, then 7. X value if it is 5 means 35. So our answer will be a multiple of 7. So option A is a correct answer, right? Okay, now let's move to the question number 2. Question number 2 is again a simple question, and Sachin is younger than Rahul by 7 years. If the ratio of their ages is 7:9, find the age of Sachin. See, Sachin and Rahul age ratio is given 7:9 and you have to find the age of Sachin. So the age of Sachin will be a factor of 7. The age of Sachin will be a factor of 7. So check option A. So option A is not divisible by 7. 7 × 3 = 21 and 2, 5, no, it will not be divisible. Option B, 7 × 3 is what? 21. 3, 5, 7 × 5 = 35. So option B is the correct answer. So just by seeing, we can find it out which option is divisible by 7. That will be our answer, right? Okay, now let's see the another method which will help you to understand how we can solve this kind of questions again without using pen and paper, right? Okay, now Sachin is younger than Rahul by 7 years. So Sachin and Rahul, the age difference is 7 years. If the ratio of their ages is 7:9, so the ratio of ages is 7:9. So if you see, the difference is what? 2. But in the question they have given, the difference is what? 7 years. The age difference is 7 years. So 2 is equals to 7. So 1 will be equal to 7/2, which is nothing but 3.5. That means Sachin age will be 7 × 3.5 and Rahul age will be 9 × 3.5. So this if we'll multiply, we'll be getting 24.5, and this if we'll multiply, we will be getting 31.5, right? 9 × 5 = 45, that means 5, 4 will be there, and 27 + 4 will be 31, right? Okay, so I told you two methods here and both the methods are easy, right? Okay, let's move to the question number 3. Question number 3 is a very important question, and this kind of questions will be generally asked in AMCAT, e-litmus TCS exams, right? Okay, so now let's see how do we solve this question. Now the ages of Kumar and Raja are in the ratio of 7:4. So Kumar and Raja, the age ratio is given 7:4. After 5 years, the ratio of their ages will become what? 11:7. So you have to find out the present age of Kumar, right? Okay, so now if you'll see in front of Kumar, what is a 7? That means the Kumar age will be a factor of 7. Now see, option A is not a multiple of 7, option B is a multiple of 7, option C is not a multiple of 7, and option D is a multiple of 7. Now we'll ask, sir, in the beginning whatever questions you solved, there was only one option which was a multiple of 7. But now what to do when there are more than one option which are multiple of 7? So what to do for that kind of questions, that we will understand here, right? Okay, so out of these two, one will be our answer, right? Okay, now what they're telling, after 5 years the ratio of their ages will be 11:7, right? Okay, so suppose if Kumar age is 14 years, see the 14 is divisible by 7, 14 is a multiple of 7. So after 5 years, it will become what? 19 years old, right? Okay, after 5 years, it will become 19 years old. That 19 should be a multiple of 11. See, now we assumed here 14 years. So after 5 years, it will become 19 years. So this 19 should be a multiple of 11, but it is not there. That means option B is wrong. You can blindly tick option D is a correct answer, right? Okay, but still we will verify here. So they are asking the present age of Kumar. So present age of Kumar, if you'll see, it is 7. So answer should be a multiple of 7. So now I am going to take 28 years. Now after 5 years, it will become what? 33 years old. Kumar will become 33 years old, and 33 is a factor of, is a multiple of 11. That means option D is the correct answer, right? Okay, now let's move to the question number 4. So question number 4 is one of the very simple question. So this question already we have done in question number 3, and it is similar to that, right? Okay. The ages of Pratik and Garima are in the ratio of 6:7. So the ages of Pratik and Garima is in the ratio of 6:7 after 6 years. So after 6 years, the ratio will become 15:17. So what is the present age of Garima, right? Okay, so the present age of Garima will be a factor of 7. So only option D will be a multiple of, or will be a factor of 7. So option D will become the correct answer for question number 4. Question number 5 is a very important question, and this question is different than whatever questions we have done till now, right? Okay, so let's see how do we solve this question. The ratio between the present age of P and Q is 6:7, right? Okay, so the ratio between the present age of P and Q is 6:7. If Q is 4 years older than P, so this statement I am not interested. What will be the ratio of ages of P and Q after 4 years? So after 4 years, you have to tell what will be the ratio of their ages, right? Okay, see, basically P age will be what? 6x. As I told in the beginning, if ratio is given, then what we can do? Then we can multiply a variable, and that will become the age of P, and this will become age of Q, right? 6x and 7x, right? Okay, now I will suppose the value of x is equals to 1. So if I'll take the value of x is equals to 1, then this will become 6, P will become 6, and Q will become what? 7. After 4 years means +4 +4, so this will become 10 and 11, but we are not finding any ratio like this, then the value of x is not possible, right? Okay, now the value of x we will keep as 2. So 6 into 2 plus 4 and 7 into 2 plus 4, so this will become 6 into 2 is 12 plus 4 is 16, and this will become 7 into 2 is 14 plus 18, so this will become 8:9. Again, this option is not there, right? Okay, now we'll keep the value as 3. So 6 into 3 is 18, 18 plus 4 is 22, and 22 is a factor of 11, so the option should be 11, but we don't have any option with 11, so that option is, I mean, x value cannot be 3 also, right? Okay, now we'll keep the value of x is equals to 4. So 6 into 4 plus 4, and 7 into 4 plus 4, so this will become 24 plus 4 28, and this will become 32. So 28:32, that means 7:8, and option A will become the correct answer. See, because I am explaining you here, so I am taking the value of x is equals to 1, 2, 3, and 4. Otherwise, you can take it directly. See, now how can you take it directly? X value is 1, so 6 plus 4 10, and 7 plus 4 11. So 10:11, there is no option. So x value 1 I cannot keep, x value 2. So 6 into 2 is 12, 12 plus 4 is 16, 16, and here if you'll see, 7 into 2 is 14 plus 4 18, 16 into 18 8:9, that is not there, so this also will not happen. X is equals to 3. 6 into 3 is 18 plus 4 12 22 22, that means that is a factor of, that is a multiple of 11, there is no option starting with 11. So x is equals to 4, if we'll put, we will be getting the answer, right? Okay, so this kind of questions will be very important. Question number 6, the sum of ages of A and B is 81 years. So the sum of ages of A and B is 81 years, and the ratio of their ages, and the ratio of their ages is 4:5. Then find out the present age of A and B. So for this kind of question, I am going to tell you one trick. That trick you have to keep in mind, and then you will be able to solve these questions very easily, right? Okay, now the sum of ages, if the sum is given, then add these two. So 4 plus 5 will become what? 9. And divide this 81 by 9. So 81 by 9, that means 9. Now the present age will be 4 into 9 and the present age will be 5 into 9. So this will be 36 and this will be 45. So the present age of A and B is 36 and 45. How simple this is, right? Okay. If you are going to solve it by normal method, still it will still take some time, right? Okay. The sum of ages of A and B is, I am repeating it, the sum of ages of A and B is 81 years and the ratio of their ages is 4 is to 5. So 4 plus 5 is 9. 81 divided by 9, that means 9. That means this will be 36 and this will be 5 into 9 will be 45. So this will be the present age of A and B, right? Okay. Now let's move to the question number 7, which is similar question. Question number 7 is one of the very important question and it is little different than whatever questions we have done till now. So let's understand how we are going to do this question without using pen and paper. The sum of ages of Ramesh and Kamal is 84 years. 6 years ago, the ratio of their ages were 5:7. Find out the present age of Ramesh and Kamal, right? Okay. So the sum of ages of Ramesh and Kamal is what? 84 years, right? Okay. And 6 years ago, 6 years ago, the ratio of their ages was what? The ratio of their ages, Ramesh and Kamal ages, was 5:7, right? Okay. So you have to find out the present age. So if I talk about 6 years before, 6 years before, then Ramesh age will be what? R-6, and the Kamal age will be what? K-6. See, suppose if my present age is 26 years old, suppose today I am 26 years old, then 6 years before I was 20 years old, right? Okay. So same thing here also. See, the total age is 84 years old, right? Okay. Now Ramesh 6 years before, that means -6, and Kamal also -6. See, total 12 will be subtracted because Ramesh will be also 6 years less 6 years before and Kamal will be also 6 years less 6 years before, right? Okay. Now if you will subtract, then 84 minus 12, it will be 72. That means the sum of ages of Ramesh and Kamal 6 years before was what? 72 years old, right? Okay. And now here you see, 6 years before, the ratio was also given 5:7. So 5 plus 7 will be equal to what? 12. Now divide 72 by 12, it will give you 6 times, right? 6 times. That means the Ramesh age 6 years before was 5:6 and the Kamal's age 6 years before was 7:6. So this will become 30. And this will become 42, right? Okay. But what has been asked in the question? Find out the present age of Ramesh and Kamal. So this is not the answer. This is the age 6 years before. This is the age 6 years before. So today's age means add plus 6 year and add plus 6 year. So this will become 36 and this will become 48, right? Okay. So that means the present age of Ramesh and Kamal is what? 36 and 48 years old. And this question, because I have explained you here, so it has taken more than 2 minutes, but you could have done it without using pen and paper. Let's see how. See, the sum of ages of Ramesh and Kamal is 84 years, right? Okay, 6 years before. 6 years before means the Ramesh age also 6 years we will subtract, and for Kamal also 6 years we will subtract. So 84 minus 12 will be 72, and 72 divided by 5 plus 7, 12, that will give you 6. That means 5 into 6 is 30, and 7 into 6 is 42. So 30 plus 6 will be the present age, and 42 plus 6 will be 48. So all those questions, whatever we did today, that questions were very much important and we have made it simple by using our tricks and techniques, right? So if you like the video, then please put a comment in the comment box so that I will be making more number of videos using the tricks. Thanks a lot.